Hey guys, another quick how-to video. Replacing the radio in my 1999 Mercedes Benz S420, also the W140. The volume knob stopped working, so I'm just gonna change the whole head unit out. To get the radio out, there's these two small slots, one and two. You can get radio removal keys for like $3 online, or just grab an old credit card or something and make it. But long story short, slide it this side in, sliding the one on that side, and the whole radio slides out. If you want to know the specifications, you can look these up. They're all over the place. I believe it was 6 millimeters by 9. I didn't even measure. I just kind of made one, eyeballed it. When you pull the radio out, you're gonna have your antenna and these two plugs on top of each other. If I can get it. There we go. Sitting like that. Push to unplug. Push them both to unplug it. This one is, I'm presuming, or assuming it's for the 6-disc CD changer in the trunk, which I'm not going to use. This is the one we're going to focus on. The parts you need. Whatever radio you want. I'm just using this cheaper Sony, just so I can have some music. This is the Bose system. The Bose system has its own amplifier, so all I need is something to send a signal to the amp. The amp's gonna power the doors and the speakers, so I don't care if this is a cheaper head unit. Sound should sound the same, but this is the one that was in there again. The parts you need, so whatever head unit you want singled in. The Bluetooth one without the CD changer is going to be a little shallower, so you have more room to work with in the back. As far as stuffing connections in, you could probably make it work with a full one if you want the CD changer. You're going to need a radio harness adapter. This is the one we're going to use. We're going to modify this to work. It's a Metra 70-1786 for Mercedes 1994-2004. And your antenna adapter is just a DB link VW12. It's literally just that little piece. Okay, first step after you do that, get your harness and go into your radio box and get your aftermarket harness. This is the one that plugs in the back of the aftermarket radio, and we're gonna connect the two of them. So just match up all the colors. This harness that we ordered has these RCA plugs. If you follow it to the base, you can see purple, gray, white, and green, right? So I'm gonna cut all these off, and I'm just gonna connect purple to purple, black to black, right? The purple with the black stripe is gonna go to the black. In case you forget, if you're holding it like this, the negative for each one of those purple, gray, white, and green is the one right next to it. For example, purple, if you snip it off, you see it's connected there. The negative is to its right. Gray, if you snip it off, it's negative to the right. Same thing with the white, same thing with the green. So if you don't want to keep track, that's how you can remember where they go. It's the harness with it snipped, or I guess the RCA is cut off it and wire stripped back. Now again, I just connect color to color, and I'm going to use these crimps. If you want to solder it, you can, but these are 22 to 18 gauge butt connectors. Here's everything connected with the butt connectors. If you want to use solder, you can. I just don't have the patience for that. The only thing I didn't connect was this orange wire. You can leave it disconnected. And just make sure it's not showing wire. You don't want it shorting out on stuff back there. Connect this to the harness. Connect our other end to the back of the radio. We'll take our antenna adapter, put it in the back of the aftermarket radio, and then that just plugs right onto it. And we'll power it up and see if it works. Connected. I'm just holding it. Pretty much see if it works. All right, powering up. Can we do this? Oh, there we go. Excuse that. So yeah, here we go. Turned it on, just a random radio station. Left works, right works, rear works, front works. And that's it. Let's see, test the memory. Start off, turn it back on, should still be on the radio. Yep, so that's it. Now I'm just gonna take the installation tray, run the wires through it. I'll just show you. The wires through the new installation cage. It has all these tabs. When you push it in all the way flush, you just bend the tabs with your fingers or screwdriver and that stops it from coming out. And then you may have to put the car in neutral. So turn the key, put the car in neutral, make sure your hand or your foot brake's on. And then you can slide the new radio in. When you're taking out the original radio, you will have to have it in neutral. And then you can put it back to park afterwards. All right, tray is in. You can give it a little shake, make sure it doesn't come out. And then slide your radio in, put your head unit on, or your faceplate. I took mine off so I don't scratch it. And that's it. Go in the settings, set it up how you want. I'm going to get rid of that annoying beeping sound whenever I move the volume knob or I'm in the settings mode. That way it's not beeping at me. And that's it. I hope this helped. If you have any questions, comment down below. If you like it, subscribe. And have a good day. This one, again, you're not going to use. Just disregard it. Hope it helps. Bye.